You know, one of the biggest problems we see with the absorbent programs that companies have in place is that the spill kit is actually being used as kind of like a repository for people to use the materials as needed. And, you know, honestly, a spill kit should be looked at as like a first aid kit.
This video is brought to you by SPC Brady, innovative absorbent and spill control products you can rely on. If you're looking for real-world insights, tips from leading industry experts, the latest trends in products and technology, you've come to the right place. From MSC Industrial Supply, this is Tooling Up.
Hello and welcome to Tooling Up. I'm your host, Tony Neary. Thanks for joining us today. We are so glad that you're here. Before we jump in with today's guest, I want to ask everybody to kind of warm up your clicking fingers. Go ahead and click those like and subscribe buttons. That way you won't miss a single upcoming episode of Tooling Up. All right, everybody subscribed? Great, let's get on with the show. Today, I'm excited to be talking about absorbents and the importance of spill control with Bobby Ennis, who's the general manager at Brady SPC. Bobby, thanks for joining us and welcome to Tooling Up.
Thanks, Tony. I'm excited to be here.
So before we get into the nitty-gritty on absorbents, why don't you spill the tea, if you'll pardon the pun, about how you ended up in your career and in your role here with Brady.
Yeah, absolutely. So mechanical engineer, by education, but oddly enough, I've always spent my professional career and roles in the environmental sector. So before coming to Brady SPC, that focus was on creating, you know, large scale, highly engineered pieces of equipment that took contaminants out of the natural gas pipeline. We did it in such a way that you didn't require filters. So we got to even, you know, remove hazardous waste contaminants from the landfill. And from there, went into the air pollution control industry where we kept pollutants and VOCs and other contaminants out of the air. So always, you know, looking for ways to help protect the environment and help make sure that work areas and you know, your local areas are free and clear of pollutants and safe for everyone to enjoy.
And I think it's amazing. So the company's been around for over, well, 110 years. And mm-hmm. I know that you mentioned when you joined Brady SPC, you went from creating high-tech solutions to low-tech, but yeah. It sounds like there's a lot more tech in some of the different products. And it even turns out there's a lot more tech than like a paper towel. So can you tell me a little bit about the technology that goes into some of that spill cleanup?
Yeah. So again, like I said, you know, the products I had developed and managed in the past, they were, you know, really easy to see how much engineering went into those things. They were designed custom for the application or for the customer need, and they were massive in scale. And now you're looking at a small product, you know, a small pad that, like I said, pretty unwhelming, but that's honestly where, you know, Brady gets an advantage. We've got that backing of the, you know, high focus of R&D that Brady puts into everything that they do, with over 250 engineers and chemists and 650 patents. The products are typically by nature hydrophobic. So you'll have an oil-only pad that is only going to attract those hydrocarbons and those oils. But then we get into adding colorants and what we call surfactants. So industry standard, you'll have a gray pad that's used to absorb all different types of liquids, and it's gray to indicate it's universal. And then you have a typically a high vis color. So we use yellow and green, but it's just a color that kind of stands out to grab attention to let you know that the liquid that's being absorbed is probably not something you want to touch with your bare hand.
All right. So my mind is blown because that's a lot of science and technology. So this low tech really is not low tech at all. I mean, we're not talking about like a standard cleanup in aisle five, right?
No, we're not. Although I'd love to help clean up the spill in aisle five as well. But, you know, like I said, the product configurations, they're designed for a reason. There's a purpose behind it and a value proposition for everything that we do and every configuration that we have. So but when you start talking about the applications like the open lathe operator, you know, you're going to have coolant spraying on it and you're going to get some of that overspray because of the turning metals. And it's just going to end up on the work, the walking surface of the operator. So you would want to use a product that has kind of like a spun bond cover stock that gives it some durability and rigidness so that you can walk on it and not worry about tearing it up. And that's where the form factor of, you know, say using a roll instead of a pad would come into hand, because that's a large surface that the operator is going to be walking on. You don't want multiple pads, you know, stacking up on each other, creating a trip hazard. You would just use a roll to create that long uniform surface.
And so you've shown a couple of the pads, and I know you have a few more examples there, but the pillows and socks are more like things I see strewn around my living room for my teenage kids. So can you talk a little bit about the application and show us like the pillows and the socks and the pads and talk about the difference between how all of those would work or how they'd be used in action?
So, you know, pillows, they look like exactly what you would think. Nice, comfortable pillows. Again, we do the color formations the same as we would with our pads. And they're intended to be used when you know you're going to have potential for drippage or a leak. So, you know, we will put these in spill kits, but just by nature of what using them on their own, it's, you know, putting them in a drip pan to put underneath a spigot, for example, so that if you're taking liquids out of a tote into a smaller container, every now and then those spigots leak just because of overuse. So you keep that there to keep and contain the liquids. And then we've got the sock options, which are more like, you know, sausages. But these are mainly intended to be put around machines or equipment, kind of like barriers along the bottom footprint. So again, you might have a piece of equipment that's got some kind of a leak or something that could allow liquids to come out from underneath it into a walkway. And by putting this barrier up, kind of keep all of that nice and tidy up underneath the equipment until either, you know, it's a weekend shutdown and you can remove the socks and put some absorbents underneath to clean it up or address what's causing the issue on your next maintenance cycle.
Perfect. And I think it's important that we touch on the kits as well, because we talked about this before and you mentioned that there's kits, but sometimes people are just kind of taking pieces and parts out of that. Do you want to talk about how a kit's comprised and why it's created and why you should have those on hand?
Absolutely. Yes. Yeah. So, you know, one of the biggest problems we see with the absorbent programs and companies have in place is that the spill kit is actually being used as kind of like a repository for people to use the materials as needed. And, you know, honestly, a spill kit should be looked at as like a first aid kit. So, you know, a lot of environments or organizations, they'll have, you know, the cabinet of Band-Aids and aspirins or whatever, right? But they also have emergency first aid kits that are meant for that quick response when something happens. And if you're pulling, you know, the Band-Aids or the gauze out of that first aid kit, when something happens, you're stuck and you don't have what you need. And a spill kit's a lot the same way.
I have to say, Bobby, like this has been such a great conversation because I know I've learned so much and hopefully everybody watching this has as well. I can't thank you enough for your time and your expertise. Your knowledge in this area is just absolutely mind-blowing and I can't thank you enough.
No, thank you for having me, Tony. It was a pleasure.
It was so great to hang out with Bobby today. And if you enjoyed our conversation as much as I did and you want to make sure that you see all of our discussions like this, go ahead and click that subscribe button for our channel so you don't miss anything. To learn more about spill control and finding the right absorbents, go to www.mscdirect.com/BradySPC. Thanks so much, and we'll see you next time on Tooling Up.
Want more insights and ideas to improve the efficiency and productivity of your operations? Check out the Tooling Up video playlist to hear tips that can take your company to the next level. And subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out.